Welcome to another interview with Proactive Investors. I'm Tanya Domkins, and today I'm joined by Lorry Hughes, Managing Director of South Boulder Mines. Lorry, thanks for joining us.
Thank you, Tanya. Nice to be here.
Lorry, South Boulder Mines and Independence Group have made significant headway at the Duketon Greenfield Nickel Project. You've termed it Australia's most exciting greenfields nickel discovery. That's a big wrap. Care to elaborate on your thoughts here?
That's very simple, Tanya. Basically, when you have numbers like 5.2 metres at 9% nickel sulphide, 1% copper, 7 grams per tonne platinum palladium element at the Rosie prospect, and then you have neighbouring 50 metres at 1% nickel sulphide at the C2 prospect, you simply don't get these type of nickel intersections unrelated to a mine development in Australia. So it's quite simple. This fantastic mineralisation has been intersected thus far, and pretty much it's open in all directions, so we can't find a better project in Australia to compare ourselves with.
Can you give investors a brief overview of the Duketon project, including the C2 and Rosie discoveries, the JV terms with Independence Group, and the potential for further exploration upside?
Okay, Tanya. Back in 2004, Independence Group and South Boulder entered the joint venture, which included a number of tenements in the Duketon Belt. And by Independence has the ability to earn a 70% interest in selected tenements within that area by delivering a bankable feasibility study. Now, the detailed terms are they have to define that study within 5 years of the grant of the relevant tenement, or if in the case of Rosie, because that's the most advanced prospect, and they've applied for a mining lease over that prospect, once that mining lease is granted, they have another 5 years to continue work to define the bankable feasibility study. There's more than enough scope for Independent to complete a number of bankable feasibility studies over a number of areas on the tenure. And like I said, the Rosie and C2 prospects are the most advanced. With regard, the joint venture holds a large tenement package. We are one of the largest holders of ground in the Duketon Belt. And Independence, like I said, they've been involved since 2004, exploring and selecting, I guess, the eyes in their minds about which tenements are the most prospective to explore. And they've been conducting small programs, and some of those programs will increase with time. Some of those areas have been taken out of the joint venture, where Independence have conducted a little bit of exploration and decided that they've downgraded particular areas. However, there are large areas that remain underexplored and unexplored within the joint venture, and we're looking to the future for South Boulder to re-explore some of those areas in our own right.
What's the timeline to progress the Duketon project to scoping study completion?
Well, Independents have now internally approved budget to commence the scoping study, and the drilling component of that study is set to begin near the end of September this year, so less than a month away. And essentially, the investment community has been waiting for this follow-up program. This will be the first follow-up drill program since the announcement of the fantastic hit in hole number 98, which was 5.2 metres at 9.2% nickel sulphide plus copper and PGE element. And essentially, once that program commences, we expect Independence Group to be very active with additional rig arriving. The scope is for 3 to 4 rigs to be drilling at once. Independents have been spending a lot of time constructing a sizable exploration camp, which has caused some of the delays in getting back out there and following up the good hit. However, they have some very advanced plans, and they are going to essentially drill out the most prospective areas on a 100 by 50 metre pattern and generate the first JORC compliant resource, in which they will start to scope the mine design of a underground development at Rosie and associated open pit development at C2, which is approximately 2 to 3 kilometres along strike. So all that work I expect to be completed by the middle of next year. And then from then, there'll be a fantastic base to make decisions whether to launch into full feasibility studies based on exploration success there.
Beyond the scoping study, what's the news flow like for the project?
Well, the scoping study itself will be generating a lot of new drill information. Once the resource is complete, then we expect to be releasing the results of the scoping study, which is the expected revenues, the expected project economics. Now, after that time, the normal expectation is to make a decision, and this will be Independence's decision. They are sole funding the project at the moment, so they are spending all the money. It will be up to them how they want to proceed. And South Boulder, if you like, is a very interested observer and partner at that point, and will continue to support Independence's plan. And typically, once a scoping study is complete and if the results are looking very positive, you can do one of two things. You can launch into a full feasibility study, a pre-feasibility study, or you can go back to the exploration and continue to add resources of the right type, whether they be low-cost resources, high-grade resources, something like that.
Lorry, thanks for talking with Proactive Investors today.
Thank you, Tanya.